So example, how do we use this knowledge? In example one, we have a methane is the fuel at 25 degrees C is burned in a stoichiometric amount of air, also at also entering the furnace at 25 degrees Celsius. Calculate or estimate the what call theoretical flame temperature. Okay, so to be able to calculate this one, first of all, we need to have a basis. Let's say we set a basis of one kilomole per hour of fuel. Okay, and we also assume that is full combustion, because you can also have a partial combustion. And below here is the full combustion reaction of methane with oxygen. So we do the balance. So basically we have an inlet of fuel plus air. Okay, so our basis is 1 kilomole of methane based on the reaction here. Okay, we need two kilomole per each kilomole of methane, so we have 2 kilomole of oxygen. And from the ratio of nitrogen to air, we can calculate air. It's basically every 1 mole of air, it is, let me calculate, 3. So this information from the ratio of oxygen and air and nitrogen in the air. So every mole of oxygen, there are 3.76 mole of nitrogen. Yeah, so here is basically 2 times 3.76. Okay, that is the inlet. So in the outlet, as you see here, so we have a product of CO2 and we have a product of hydrogen, and remember we also have a nitrogen that come in. So based on this stoichiometric reaction, we have 1 kilomole of CO2, 2 kilomole, sorry, this is not stoichiometry, it has to be 2 here, so 2 kilomole of water. And lastly we have, because nitrogen is inert, we have the same amount of nitrogen that come in and goes out, come into the furnace and goes out from the furnace. So step number one, we need to assume the basis. Based on the basis, we perform the we write the chemical stoichiometric chemical reaction, then perform the mass balance in and outlet, and lastly we have to identify one by one. So first of all, because we want the flame temperature, theoretical flame temperature, we assume that it is adiabatic. So it adiabatic means delta heat of combustion. So delta heat of the whole system is equal to zero. Okay, all of the heat from the fuel is used to increase the temperature of the product gas. Okay, that's fine. So delta H1 is integral Cp dT. This is equal to zero. Why? Because the methane enter the system at standard condition. So basically it's integral from 25 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius, so it's end up become zero. Delta standard heat of reaction, delta H2, is equal to this amount. You can find this value from the table given below, from the table, either the one provided in the slide, or you can find it in the any chemical engineering textbooks. Then we have a delta H3, delta H3 there, delta H3, we know that T standard is 25 degrees Celsius, but we don't know the theoretical flame temperature. So basically, we cannot solve it. We cannot do the integration. So what we do is we do trial and error by just guessing. So what is the best guess? The best guess will be around 1,500 to, I think, 2,500, something around that one. So in this example, we guess first at the theoretical flame temperature of 2,000 degrees Celsius. So we can calculate delta H3. So this is basically the average CV, 1 mole of CH4 times the average heat capacity of CH4. This is 2 mole of oxygen. This is CV of the oxygen, and this is CV for nitrogen, and this one is standard condition, 25 degrees Celsius equal to 298 Kelvin, and this is the TFT, which is we guess first at 2000. So you bring it all and you will find out that delta H3 equal to this guy. Okay, then we find out that okay, the TFT based on our calculation is 2062. So since 2062 is quite close to 2000, so basically we can accept this one. So the answer will be around, well, probably less than 2062, but above 2000 if you want to go into a more precise solution.